Sei incidental, se me ocurrió buena idea enseñártelo. No soy una persona coordinada, soy torpe, which means I'm not a very coordinated person. I'm actually quite clumsy. Se me ocurrieron muchos accidentes, which means accidents often happen to me. Now, I'm not saying that I'm the reason for these accidents. I'm saying the accidents happen indirectly to me. And that's what we're learning today, is we're learning to take away culpability from an action. So if I say quebré mi teléfono, I'm saying I broke my phone. That means that I take on the responsibility for the actual breaking of my phone. However, if I say se me quebró mi teléfono, I'm saying that the phone broke. It just happened to happen to me. I'm putting culpability on the phone as opposed to myself. So this is what we're learning in Spanish class. We're learning how to take a sentence like quebré mi teléfono and we're changing it to se me quebró el teléfono. Again, to kind of take away the culpability from someone. So the first step, again, is to start with se. Se is usually used in passive constructions, and in this case, it helps us take away, like I said, that culpability from ourselves. Step two is that we need to choose an indirect object pronoun. This is who is indirectly impacted by the action. So, for example, se me quebró el teléfono, like I said earlier, means that I'm indirectly impacted by the breaking of the phone. But if I say se te quebró el teléfono, I'm saying that that's occurring to you, or le or nos or les, depending on who your subject, excuse me, your indirect object is. Step three is change the verb to match the direct object. Now you notice that el teléfono is a singular noun. And if I'm using it in a subject sentence, I would conjugate the verb to be third person in singular. That's why we use quebró el teléfono instead of quebré. Again, I'm making the phone take on the responsibility. If I had teléfonos, what I would do is change quebré to quebraron. Se me quebraron los teléfonos. The two phones broke. And it occurred to me. So let's try it out. Mi amigo olvidó las llaves. First thing I'm going to do is put a se. Second step is I need to figure out who's this occurring to. Oh, it's mi amigo. What's an indirect object pronoun for mi amigo? Le. Great. And then finally, las llaves. Las llaves son, in this case, the object that I forgot or my friend forgot. So because it's third person, plural, I'm going to change olvidar to olvidaron. Se le olvidaron las llaves means that the keys were forgotten and happened to my friend. And guess what? Because we use an indirect object pronoun, it is possible to have a referent. So I could say, a mi amigo se le olvidaron las llaves. Now we can't say mi amigo se le olvidaron las llaves because we're putting the culpability on the keys. So we can't have two subjects in the sentence. So the a mi amigo, again, as we've learned in previous lessons, refers to the indirect object pronoun. Los chicos perdieron la tarjeta codificada para su habitación. So the kids forgot their coded key in their hotel room, and it's for their hotel room. This is a very common problem. If I really want to take away the culpability from these chicos, how would I do this? You got it. It'd be se les perdió la tarjeta codificada. Now, why is it like this? Se, because I'm taking away the responsibility. Les, because I have los chicos. And perdió, because I have una tarjeta, one coded card. Now, if I wanted to refer to the chicos in more specificity, I would say, a los chicos se les perdió la tarjeta codificada. So here's the formula. Again, it's very simple. All of our statements are going to be starting with se. That takes away that culpability. Next, we're going to add an indirect object pronoun. Se me means it indirectly impacts me. Se te, it indirectly impacts you. Se le, it indirectly impacts él or ella or usted. Se nos means it indirectly impacts us. Y se les, ellos, ellas, ustedes. You get the picture. It depends on who it's impacting. Finally, we have to come with the last section of the sentence. Se me quedó la mochila versus se te quedaron las llaves. Notice that I have the verb quedar, which means to be left behind. If I say se me quedó la mochila, the reason why it's quedó is because mochila is singular. So the backpack was left, it just happened to me. Or las llaves quedaron, the keys were left behind, but it happened to you. Again, que that is going to change according to the object, not the indirect object pronoun. I can also say, se le cayó el libro y se nos cayeron las aspirinas. Cayó el libro, again, because libro is singular, and cayeron las aspirinas because aspirinas are plural. It does not have to modify our indirect object pronoun. And finally, se les dañó el coche. El coche, the car, got damaged and happened to them. This is a great excuse to use in Spanish when you get into a car accident. So, what are some verbs that allow us to take away this culpability and use the se incidental construction? Caer, to fall, to drop. Dañar, to damage, to break down. Olvidar, to forget. Perder, to lose. Quedar, to be left behind. Y romper, to break. So, I want us to try it out. Here's an example. Yo caer el vidrio. I want to say that the glass didn't fall because it's my fault. I want to say the glass fell and it happened to me. So again, I start with se. Then I look at who it impacted. It's myself. So me is my pronoun. And then finally, el vidrio singular. I want to use cayó because it's a singular third person construction. And then my sentence is se me cayó el vidrio. So what I'd like you to do is go ahead and using the sentence frames, do 1 through 5 in your notes. Buena suerte, and I'm very much looking forward to us making more excuses together in Spanish. Adios.